Well, Shep, the governor apologized over and over for making others feel uncomfortable. He explained, look, it's just the way he greets people. It's the way his father, Governor Mario Cuomo, greeted people. Still, there's a disconnect here between this picture and his statement.
I never touched anyone inappropriately. I never touched anyone inappropriately. I never knew at the time that I was making anyone feel uncomfortable.
Former staffer Lindsay Boylan was the first to come forward, accusing the governor of giving her a kiss she didn't want. He denied it. She tweeted today after Cuomo's comments, "How can New Yorkers trust you, Governor Cuomo, to lead our state if you don't know when you've been inappropriate with your own staff?" Cuomo says he's taken the sexual harassment training required of all state workers. He admitted he's deeply embarrassed, but said he wasn't ashamed of anything he's done in his public career. Cuomo urged New Yorkers to wait for the inquiry from the Attorney General's office before passing judgment, Shep.
Contessa, Cuomo insists that he will not resign, that the challenges of the pandemic and the state finances are all present challenges that the voters elected him to tackle. Does he still have voter confidence?
Yeah, a poll this week shows he has only 38% approval and 64% say he shouldn't be reelected in 2022. A federal investigation opened into the way the state reported COVID deaths for nursing home residents, and it's weighing on Cuomo's approval ratings. And then today, state Republicans once again demanded impeachment of Governor Cuomo, Shep.
Contessa Brewer, thank you.
Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.